Great, thanks very much indeed. Where to begin? Well, Derek and I have been working together since you were 4 years old, Derek.
4 years old.
And in about 4 weeks' time, Derek's going to be 33, so that's quite a lot of life, isn't it? Just flown under the bridge. When Derek was four, the very very first thing I heard you play, do you remember what it was, Derek?
Argentina?
Yeah.
Don't cry for me, Argentina it was, Adam.
Which we'll hear in a minute. I think the most amazing thing about Derek and lots of the other children I work with is not so much that they are able to develop these extraordinary musical talents, but that they do it on their own. Musicality starts to develop really when you're about 2 years old. In fact, by the age of two, most of your auditory processing is already in place. And your musical ear, Derek, which enables you to do what you do today, was in place by the time you were two, which is actually when Derek started playing the piano. And people have been asking us how you do it, haven't they? And I think the real thing is it's this absolute pitch, which about 5% of children with autism have. And really, all absolute pitch means, in a nutshell, is that for Derek and other people like him, every single note on the piano is just like a familiar friend, really. For most of us in the room, if I just play a note, it just sounds a bit high or a bit low, a bit lower. Whereas for Derek, that is a distinct friend, isn't it, Derek? And if I play any note, yes, just one would. Each of the 88 is quite different. And also, I think, again for you, Derek, like a lot of the people I work with, it's not just about single sound, it's about quite complicated sound. I think it's true to say, Derek, you found the train up from Euston to Preston was quite boring because it was one of those Virgin trains that doesn't make many noises, whereas the little train from Preston to Ormskirk was extremely interesting because it made all sorts of weird noises, like it was going to stop at any moment. But I noticed that Derek is perked up. And so when the train is making quite complicated sounds, perhaps like this, Derek can hear all of those things. In fact, we know from research that you can hear at least 10 notes at once, Derek, straight away and process them. And again, I think that's fairly characteristic of these 5% of children with autism who have absolute pitch. But enough of me going on. What about playing the very first piece that your nanny heard you play when you were about two and a half, Derek, for what that one was?
I can. Cockles and Muscles?
Yep, this was the first time people knew Derek was in musical when he played Cockles and Muscles.
Molly Malone.
Right, is this on?
It is on. We were just having lunch with Temple, and Derek said, what piece would you like me to play? And you said, Stay Away to Heaven, which I think you thought meant was Stay Away from Heaven, Derek. Anyway, we managed to download it on YouTube, and so this is Derek's version of Stay Away to Heaven, having heard it on YouTube over lunch. Go green. Now, when Derek, when you came up 2 years ago, Jude was about to have a special birthday that ends in zero. Okay?
Yeah.
And some of Jude's friends got together and sent Derek an email saying, would you mind playing Hey Jude and putting it on a CD for her birthday? So this is what he did.
Okay.
You were made to Yay! Yeah, so.
Great. Now, in a minute, it's over to you, what you'd like Derek to play, or any questions you'd like to ask.
Yeah.
I think we'll do one more, though, to show, I suppose, the beginning of our relationship, really, which was very much around early jazz, sort of things like Fats Waller and Art Tatum and people like that. Here's one of your favourites, Derek, called Tiger Rag.
Tiger Rag!
Got any requests, don't you?
Yeah. Have you got any requests of a tune that you'd like me to play?
Rhapsody in Blue.
Can do Rhapsody in Blue.
Rhapsody in Blue is 18 minutes long. here's the from Rhapsody in Blue.
It's Gershwin, isn't it?
It is Gershwin.
Just a flight.
Strawberry Beer.
I have to make up a piece on using three different notes.
So you have to choose three different notes.
A.
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 F.
F. F. C sharp.
Isn't that funny? You should say that. Yes.
That's a very mean choice. This is going to be called the Ormskirk Blues.
Ormskirk Blues.
Someone over there, Derek.
Would you like some music over there for me to play?
Yes. Thank you for the music.
Thank you for the music from ABBA.
Derek, do you want to choose one?
I would like to choose one, please, Adam. Can I choose Wish I Knew How It Felt to Be Free by Billy Taylor?
Yep, this is a great number. Billy Taylor was a great jazz pianist who died a couple of years ago. And this piece was made famous from the film, whatever it is, film 90, film 91, film 92. This was the theme music.
Thank you.
Do you think, Derek, it's time for someone else to have a turn?
Yes,
a turn.
A turn.
We were in Slovenia last year, and in fact, a chat with Autism came up, because he's always wanted to play with you, Derek. And in fact, this is what he played.
Like chopsticks, version of chopsticks, I think.
And what happened next was very special. Does anyone know how to play chopsticks? They must.
Yeah,
I can see you do. Come on. Just play one note of it. How are you?
Brilliant.
I'll tell you where to start, don't I? I won't tell you where to start. Right, okay.
You, Derek, you sit down.
And what's your name? Can I
Victoria, say hello.
Hello, Victoria.
Hello. You didn't think this was going to happen when you had your breakfast this morning. You want to sit there? Yeah, better off. Victoria's going to start.
Okay.
Tell me what your name.
Yeah.
Now, Derek, let's start with Victoria. Do you know that much?
Yeah.
Do you know any of it?
I don't even
know. Oh, that's fine. Right,
Derek, wait.
Just a minute.
Put my microphone down. Victoria, let's go. No, that's another one, but don't worry. Go on, just do this bit. Okay. Victoria and I are going to do a duet. Okay, go on. One, two, three, one, two, three. Wait, Derek, wait. Go on. Go on, go on. Go on, just play that note. Go on, keep going. Keep going. Wait, Derek. Keep going.
Hear a piece of music, we hear the tune basically, like say it was, like chopsticks for example, we just hear the top part. What people like Derek hears is actually from the bottom up. So if he's listening to an orchestra or a band or a choir, he hears the bass line and then goes up. So he's hearing much more structurally actually. And a lot of the kids I teach, sometimes when you ask them to play a piece, they actually like starting with the left hand, starting with what's down the lower notes, because those are the ones they're hearing, which is kind of the structure on which music's built, and Derek's the same. So a very simple, just one note like that, Derek can play fantastic chords against it. I'll just move you up a bit, Derek.
I can chords against it, yeah.
So do a few chords, really. I'll go and play different notes, you shot.
Just make some chords up. Come on, Derek, up. Up.
One more tune.
Not all over the world,
can do
status quo. Not the Beethoven version, Derek.
What's that?
Just being funny. Go on. Because they've got absolute pitch, about always playing the piece at the note they hear. So for example, Twinkle Twinkle Little Stars usually starts on C. And so I always get the children to play starting on every note right from the start, including you, Derek. So when you were little, we used to do
scales
in every different piece. So every piece that you play, Derek, every different piece you play is available in every key, which is quite extraordinary and extremely useful if you're a singer, for example. So things like Flight of the Bumblebee, which is an incredibly hard piece to play. You can just, I know you can play on any key, Derek, so just say F sharp. Or if I said B flat. And so on. And that's hugely useful. And most people don't recognise how clever it is because they think, well, it's obvious he can do it, but it takes years and years and years of practice. And I suppose the final message is that what people don't always realise when they see you, Derek, is they think it's a sort of, they use the word gifted and so on, but really it's just hard work. And there's a rule that says 10,000 hours is what you need to achieve anything. And of course, a lot of people with autism do fix on things and spend an awful lot of time on them. And certainly, Derek, you've spent, I should think, 50,000 hours playing the piano, which, given your against the backdrop of a propensity to listen to sound and the fascination of music, of course, has led to talent. But I'm absolutely sure there's a lot more children out there who perhaps don't go recognised. Perhaps they're the children that are flicking flower pots or spinning around in circles with CDs or DVDs or whistling to themselves. And very often that sort of could be a sign of sort of trapped musicality. So I suppose my message is always look for the musical in a child, because I know every school I go to, there's always two or three who do have special potential waiting to come out. Should we finish with a couple more numbers, Derek?
Finish with a couple more numbers, Adam.
You do, what about I've Got Rhythm? That's good.
We could do I've Got Rhythm.